the PBS Script Generator was created to make writing job submission scripts easier for users. We created this specifically for our systems and keep it updated as much as possible. The page lists a lot of options to choose from. You must simply select which options you need and set the correct resource requests. The script will then be generated below for you to copy and paste. One of the best ways to learn proper submission syntax is to test different options and see how the script changes. At the top of the page, the script generator asks you about your resource requests. Select the number of nodes or servers that your job needs. Unless you are using MPI, this number is usually 1. Then select the appropriate number of processors per node that you need. In this example, we'll choose 4 processors on 1 node. This is functionally equivalent to saying that your job could run on a computer with a quad-core processor. Let's look below at how the script was updated to match this request. Here is the -L line that shows the node and PPN request. Some users use MPI or other mechanisms for their jobs and don't care if they get 8 processors on 2 nodes or 4 processors on 4 nodes. If that describes your jobs, you may look into using the proc equals option. Next is the memory request. Most users should choose the per processor option to choose how much memory they need per processor. There is also a per job option that will divide that number among all the requested processors. There has probably been one user in several years who has needed to check the following box, so we will ignore it. Next, you can input your wall time in hours, minutes, and seconds. The following checkboxes allow you to choose if you want to run the job as a test job, preemptible, a preemptible requeuable job, or run the job using MPI exec. Most users don't need to check any of these checkboxes. The next checkbox sets up the job so that output files can be read by a group, if that is necessary for you. Just check the box and specify the group name. You can also give the job a name if you'd like. The following 2 rows will change the settings for notification emails. You can receive emails when a job begins, and successfully, or aborts. The next 2 lines specify the path to the executable and what options to run it with. The line after that allows you to specify what file to send the standard output to. The next section has a list of features that your job can request. In general, you want to choose the fewest number of features possible, since each extra feature limits the amount of nodes that your job can run on. The numbers below the feature name indicate how many of the installed nodes and processors are actually available at this point in time. The box below the features attempts to figure out how many processors and full nodes are available based on your resource requests. This should be regarded as mostly, but not 100% accurate. Note that some resource requests result in impossible situations, like requesting the AMD and Intel features. There are no nodes that have both an Intel and an AMD processor. Down at the very bottom of the page is the result of all our work. This is a script that you should be able to copy and paste into a file for submission to the scheduling system. You can quickly learn the submission syntax by visiting this page often and playing with different settings. If you still have questions, please open a support ticket on our website and we would be happy to assist you in learning more.